the introduction of nuclear arms at the close of World War II, the stage was set for the future development of nuclear arms globally. The United States had been looking for a possible short-range atomic weapon with the potential for deploying through a static artillery piece. With the government's increasing interest in the capability and deployment of nuclear arms, the idea of a self-propelled gun with a nuclear capability was seriously looked into, leading to the government tasking the Picatinny Arsenal with creating a nuclear-capable artillery piece in 1949. Developed over 3 years during the 1950s, with the preliminary designs being completed by Robert Schwartz, the M65 atomic cannon was designed and initially based off the designs of the German railroad guns of the Second World War, with originally a 240mm, then an upscaled 280mm barrel, with an interrupted screw-willin breech block. The entire assembly would weigh 172,865 pounds, consisting of a crew of 5 to 7 troops, yet on occasion reporting up to 20. The cannon was transported by 2 specialized independent heavy-duty 4x4 trucks on each end. The trucks were specifically produced for the project, with the designations M249 Heavy Gun Lifting Front Truck and the M250 Rear, respectively. The trucks were produced by the Kenworth Motor Truck Company, with each truck rated at 375 horsepower with a top speed of 56 kilometers an hour or 35 miles per hour. The trucks would be operated by a driver at the front and the rear, with the front driver controlling most of the controls and with the communication being accomplished via headset comms. Upon deployment, the carriage designated M30 would be lowered to the ground and the cannon would remain placed on a ball and socket joint at its base to allow traverse of the cannon. In 1953, during Operation Upshot Knothole at the nuclear testing ground Frenchman Flat in Nevada, the test codename Grabble was put into motion to test the effectiveness of the M65. The M65 fired a W9 15 kiloton nuclear warhead over 11 kilometers, being the first and only nuclear weapon to be launched from a cannon. The cannon operated with a double recoil system, with the gun itself containing a self-dampening system, as well as the carriage itself, reducing the immense recoil on both fronts. The gun itself would need to be specifically positioned for firing with the chassis faced at an angle to the cannon. This was done to prevent the blast from shattering the cab windows. The cost of one M65 unit would be roughly $800,000, with 20 having been produced by the Pittsburgh-based Dravo Corporation at the height of its development from 1951 to 1953. During the Cold War and the Korean War, the M65 was deployed in locations throughout Korea and Europe, as well as areas of Japan from 1955 to 1962. With the large size of the M65, the cannon would have to be moved from location to location often, as its great size made it easy to detect, leaving the cannon vulnerable and thus being moved to avoid detection. The cannon itself, soon after its deployment, would be seen as obsolete due to the development of the Honest John surface-to-surface tactical nuclear missile, which had been produced around the same time as the M65. Its obsolescence did not lead to its neglect, as the cannons would remain in theater due to their prestigious nature, and the notion of having nuclear-capable artillery behind them surely bolstered morale in infantry. Another factor to consider is that air-based weapons are environmentally specific, whereas the M65 is capable of combat operation day or night, and in any weather, unlike nuclear-capable aircraft. A number of problems would eventually present themselves, from the point of administration as well as the troops deployed. The M65 had an extremely difficult time making turns on roads less than 8 meters in width, with reported instances of buildings in Germany being destroyed from the cannon's passage. With the further development of nuclear-capable weapons, the M65 became very quickly obsolete and would be removed from service following 1963. The system itself would present some issues in the field, such as being that the barrel was so considerably heavy, should it through flaw or error unmount the barrel assembly, it would require a transport helicopter to get to the location of the gun to lift the barrel back into position. The barrels themselves had a considerably short lifetime, and would be permitted to test fire twice yearly to preserve barrel life. During these shoots, it was said that despite all the weight and emplacement measures, the entire platform would lift off the ground due to the immense recoil. The breech would require 2 men to open and would take roughly 15 minutes to be prepared for firing from the transport phase. With only 7 of the 20 surviving to this day, the remaining examples of the M65 atomic cannon are on display, with the most notable gun number 9, Atomic Annie, being on display at Fort Sill in Oklahoma.